This is an original poster from 1895 by artist Jules Cheret. The poster was in horrible condition, and we brought it back to life. Take a look. When we got this poster, it was on an old dry linen backing. It had breaks in the paper, although the linen backing was holding it together. Once we took the old canvas off, the breaks became more apparent. We are putting it back together on a new linen backing. This bio of Jules Cheret is from Britannica. Jules Cheret, born in 1836 in Paris, France, and died in Nice, France in 1933. He was a French poster illustrator and graphic designer who has been called, quote, the father of the modern poster, unquote. After apprenticing as a lithographer from 1849 and studying drawing, Cheret received his first major poster commission in 1858 for Jacques Offenbach's operetta, Orpheus in the Underworld. And from 1859 to 1866, he designed posters and book jackets in London. He also created packages for perfume manufacturer Eugene Rimmel, whose funding enabled Cheret to establish a lithography firm in Paris in 1866. When this paper gets wet, it absorbs the moisture very quickly, and as you can see, when it's wet, it gets darker. But the paper will lighten again once it's dry. Owning his own firm allowed Cheret to maintain artistic control and to establish an innovative design approach. Most lithographers of the time commissioned an artist to create a poster design, which was then copied onto a stone by a skilled craftsman. Cheret, however, worked directly on the stone, using spirited brush lines, crosshatch, stipple, soft watercolor-like washes, and areas of flat color to create a dynamic image. Throughout the 1870s and 80s, his style evolved from one typical of Victorian graphics, that is, dominated by complex decoration, to a simpler, more dynamic approach in which compositions were dominated by large central figures, prominent hand-lettered titles, simplified backgrounds, and large areas of glowing color and gestural textures. His artistic influences included the idyllic romances of the Rococo painters Antoine Watteau and Jean-Honoré Fragonard, the churning compositions of Baroque painter Giovanni Battista Tiepolo, and the flat color and stylized linear contours of Japanese woodblock prints.
I think I'm going to stop it at this point, let it dry, let my wife recreate the rest. My wife and I, actually.
Is your poster in as bad a shape as this poster from the 1890s by Jules Cheret? Let's hope not. But you know what, after 31 years, more than 31 years, of restoring vintage posters, nothing surprises me, and I've seen a lot worse.
Well, we've got the poster on the table now. A few days have passed, and it's dry. I've drawn lines around it.
And now I'm drawing the lines to show the boundaries, the edges of the poster where the paper fill will go to. In 1890, the French government awarded Cheret the Legion of Honor, citing his creation of an art form that advanced printing and also served the needs of commerce and industry. By the end of his career, Cheret had designed over 1,000 posters for music halls, theaters, performers, and products, including beverages, medicines, and lamp oil.
This one is correct.
The full line. Don't you know it is?
Oki is going to do the paper fills on this poster using methyl cellulose mixed with paper pulp. This is our own concoction. Nobody else does it. And we don't really show you how we make it exactly because it's our trade secret.
No thanks, I'm gonna have my muffin later. Paper pulp. A mixture of paper powder and methyl cellulose.
Edible.
Edible for flies, maybe. Yeah, I wonder what happened to Gray.
I think it's growing inside.
I've never seen a cat on a Cheret poster before.
There's a black cat. One Cheret poster has a black cat.
Oh, one Cheret poster has a black cat?
Yeah, cool.
Are you sure it's Cheret and not Steinland?
I don't know.
Yeah, same period. There's one artist that did a lot of cats. Steinland.
For doing the color retouching of this poster, the in painting, we used gouache, watercolor, and also watercolor pencils. All of these materials are water-based and reversible and archival. After 31 plus years of restoring vintage posters, this Cheret is probably one of the nicest Cherets I've ever gotten. It's really a fine example of his best work.
What? Wow, doing a great job.
You like this color?
Yeah, once it's all covered, it'll look fine.
Here it looks, but this is a natural paper and this is color.
Yeah, it looks good there, so.
But here,
I know, it gets darker down there because it gets stained down here. It's stained.
After 31 plus years of restoring vintage posters, this Cheret is probably one of the nicest Cherets I've ever gotten. It's really a fine example of his best work.
Yeah, okay. Looks good.
One look at the woman on this poster and you can think that she must be a free-spirited, happy person. Previous to Cheret's time, women in posters were depicted either as Puritans or prostitutes. Cheret's are neither. They're lively, liberated women. They are enjoying various activities, smoking, bicycling, drinking, have low-cut dresses. They're free. They're different. They are women of the modern age. The lettering is a specialty in and of itself. My wife Oki has many years of calligraphy and letter reproduction experience, as well as being a very talented and gifted artist in her own right. I had a hard time finding what all the lettering was meant to be, as not all the pieces had survived from this poster, and I had to look it up online and find some high-resolution photographs to work from. It wasn't easy to find what I needed. In 1895, Cheret created the Maître de l'Affiche collection, a significant art publication of smaller-sized reproductions featuring the best works of 97 Parisian artists. You can see a lot of famous posters reproduced that way in a miniature size. The lithography is top-notch and they look just spectacular. They have a whole collecting world in and of themselves. Cheret's success inspired an industry that saw the emergence of a new generation of poster designers and painters such as Charles Gesmar and Toulouse-Lautrec, and one of his students was Georges Dufour, who was a really good poster designer. In his old age, Cheret retired to the pleasant climate of the French Riviera at Nice. He died in 1932 at the age of 96 and was interred at the Cemetery Saint Vincent in the Montmartre quarter of Paris. Boy, my French is really crappy. I have to say, over the years, I've worked for many a poster dealer, and I found that Cheret's posters were among the best selling of all the French Art Nouveau period posters. Cheret was very highly collected by the wealthy of Long Island, Connecticut, and other places in the United States and abroad. Thank you.
Wow, you already did that? I believe it's 1:35
35?
I think so.
Not 5:5?
No.
God, I can't believe how fast you are, Oki.
Finished?
I think so.
That is a fantastic job, one of the best jobs you have ever done in the years and years you have worked with me. You are the best. This poster is 125 years old, but it doesn't look it. We have made this poster presentable again. We have made this poster great again. This is Chris. After 31 years of restoring posters, I still look forward to seeing yours. Thank you.